Praise the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah. Keep the faith and hold on. Hallelujah. God is so good. It's time now for the Word of God, and I would just like to encourage you to open up your heart. Let that Word be a reflection of your life, not for somebody else, but for you, because it's from each of us, each and every one of us is a Word for us today, making us ready for that great day when our change will come. Amen. It's time now to introduce our pastor. He is the watchman of our souls, Pastor Dorian Richardson. Please welcome him with Preach the Word as he comes. Preach the Word.
Amen. Somebody say, hold out. A little while longer. Amen. I feel like singing, but the hour's getting away from us. Amen. You didn't come to hear me sing. Amen. We came to hear the word of the Lord. Can the church say hallelujah? But I will sing if you want me to. Praise the Lord. Hold to his hand, God's unchanging hand. Come on and hold to his hand, God's unchanging hand. Build your hopes on something eternal. Hold to God's unchanging hand. Everybody ought to hold to his hand, God's unchanging hand. Come on and hold to his hand. All right. God's unchanging hand. Build your hopes on things eternal. And hold to God's unchanging hand. Everybody ought to hold to his hand. God's unchanging hand. Come on and hold to his hand. That's right. God's unchanging hand. You gonna make it. Build your hopes on things eternal and hold to God's unchanging hand. Oh yes, let's hold to his hand. Come on, saints. God's unchanging hand. Come on and hold to his hand. God's unchanging hand. I'm building my hopes on things eternal, and I hold to God's unchanging hand. Everybody got to hold to his hand. You better hold on to Jesus. God's unchanging hand. You're going to get a job. Hallelujah. Hold. Hallelujah. God's unchanging hand. And build your hopes on things eternal. And hold to God. One more time. Hallelujah. Come on, let's hold. Yeah, God's son, I got to hold. Well, God's unchanging hand, I'm building. Build your hopes on things eternal, and I hold to God's unchanging hand. Hallelujah. Glory. Amen. Hallelujah. Ain't he all right tonight? Amen. Ain't he all right this morning? The Lord is all right with me. Amen. I'm holding to his hand, his unchanging hand. Amen. There's a lot of things that change, saints. Amen. But we thank God today that the Lord, he don't change up on you. Can the church say amen? He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Can the church say praise the Lord? Amen. The hour's getting away from us, so I want to go into the word of the Lord today. Let's go to Mark chapter number 8. Mark chapter number 8. And we're interested in verses numbers 22 through 26 in your hearing. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. When you have it, you can say amen. You look good today. Amen. The good crowd out today. God bless you. So let's read here. And it cometh to Bethsaida, and they bring a blind man unto him, and he besought him to touch him. And he took the blind man by the hand and led him out of town. And when he had spit in his eyes, he put his hands upon him and asked him if he saw aught. And he looked up and said, I see men as trees walking. And after that, he had put his hand again upon his eyes and made him look up, and he was restored. And he saw every man clearly. Hallelujah. And he sent him away to his house, saying, neither go to the town, nor tell it to any in the town. That's it. That's good enough right there. Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you, my God, for thy goodness, for your kindness, Lord. For we are nothing without you, Lord. We will but fail, Lord. Speak to us, O Lord. Help us to walk with you. Help us, O God, to serve you, Lord. We thank you, my God, for your word. My God, let your will be done, O God, in this place. We give you the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I want to read verses numbers 22 again. And he cometh to Bethsaida. And they bring him a blind man, unto him and besought him to touch him. I want to talk to us from this particular thought. it's time to come out. And as a sub-thought, you need a change of scenery. You need a change of scenery. This particular town, Bethsaida, is one of the towns that Jesus did many mighty miracles and works in. It is referred to as one of the towns in the 11th chapter of the book of Matthew, from verses numbers 20 through 24, one of the particular towns that Jesus literally cursed. It was Bethsaida, Capernaum, and Chorazin. Three particular towns that Jesus cursed because the fact that there was many mighty works that was done in the midst of them. And yet they would not believe. Praise the Lord. He even speaks of them in that particular chapter, chapter 11 of Matthew. He speaks of in reference to these particular cities, that if these works were done in Sodom, that they would have repented. In this, we see the fact that God had allowed many mighty miracles to be performed in their midst. But yet and still, brothers and sisters, it did not sway their opinion of him. So it shows us the fact that while the information and the revelation, the knowledge, the truth, because Jesus is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life, can be made available, it does not always accomplish, amen, the desired result. Even though I understand that God's word will accomplish whereunto it is sent. But we also have to understand that it is not God's will that any should perish. It is not God's desire that anybody would be lost. The Bible said he would have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. So it is somewhat of a revelatory or wonderful thing that was done to this particular blind man. But yet it also reveals a great truth as to how Jesus dealt with these particular individuals within the confines of Bethsaida. Can the church say amen? The Bible is clear, praise God, that this man was brought to him in the town. He was brought to him within the confines, praise God, of this particular city. But the scripture tells us that Jesus led him by hand out of the city, healed him there. Can the church say amen? I don't have all of the particulars of the man's specific condition and how he got into it. He could have been born blind. He could have went blind. He could have got hooked up in this particular city and got himself in some trouble and lost his sight. The scriptures are not particular as to tell us that. But we do understand that there is something to be seen in this particular, as it were, story about how God dealt with this man's faith and how he dealt with this city. Can the church say amen? Jesus takes the man and leads him out of the city, literally spits in his eyes. Now, most of us in here, if somebody spit in your eyes, you would need the Holy Ghost to give you all the strength that you had to stay saved. Can the church say amen? Amen. But if I, amen. But this particular man couldn't see it coming. Can the church say amen? For all we know, he could have been water being put in his eyes. But the application is not that important. Amen. As to how God accomplished it. But the lesson behind Praise God. The story is what I want to drive home today. Amen. And the mere fact that he did this in this manner, praise the Lord. It is apparent that God had already, amen, allowed Bethsaida, amen, or this particular city, as it were, to hear the truth. Amen. This was one of the cities that he did many mighty works in. Praise God. But it did not, amen, cause them saints to turn from, praise God, the evil of their ways. Amen. Because somebody said in one place that man's heart in him is set to do evil. There are certain people that are bent on doing what they want to do. Amen. No matter what anybody says, no matter what anybody does. Amen. So Jesus, amen, while dealing with this man's faith, amen, because of the unbelief of the town in which he lived in, amen, Jesus did not want the town, amen, to get the benefits of the man's faith. Can the church say amen? And I don't know about you today, but I don't want to get to a place, amen, hallelujah, where God is not able, amen, because of my unbelief to allow my faith to be increased. It would seem, brothers and sisters, that these individuals would, amen, hallelujah, been flocking to Jesus. It would seem that these individuals, praise God, would have loved to see Jesus coming. Amen. But I want you to know that as it pertains to this particular man, amen, God was merciful to him. Amen. Yet, on the other hand, he did not want, praise God, those unbelievers to hear anymore. Praise the Lord, because they refused to hear him. At the first, can the church say amen? Amen. So what I'm trying to get across to you today, that it is imperative. Amen. It is of the utmost importance that whenever we come in contact with God, amen, whenever we see God moving, whenever, amen, God speaks to us, that we are willing to, praise God, take him at his word. Praise the Lord. We are willing to allow him to do what he wants to do in all of our lives. Amen. Hallelujah. He says, amen. In the other text, he says, woe unto, amen, these particular cities, praise God, because they abraded him, praise the Lord. They threw away, praise God, the prince of princes. They threw away the truth, hallelujah, from out of their eyes. They did not want to hear him. And the church say amen. They did not want to allow God to, amen, take hold in their life, praise the Lord. But I want you to know there's always, praise the Lord, a ram in the bush. Amen. There's always somebody, saints, hallelujah, amen, that's going to believe God. There's always somebody, amen, that's going to trust him. There's always somebody that is going to love him. Can the church say amen? Amen. So we find in this particular text, praise God, the mercy of God, hallelujah, coming upon one man, amen, one man that was blind, that could not see, amen, hallelujah, possibly having to be led about day by day, amen, by the hand. Hallelujah. Amen. Probably didn't have an occupation. Didn't have a way to sustain his living. Amen. But because, hallelujah, God saw his heart, Brother Bobby, and saw his need. Amen. God looked beyond all of the faults of the man. And amen. In spite, praise God, of the wretchedness and the disbelief, thank you, Holy Ghost, of those that were around him. Praise the Lord. He took him by the hand, saints. Thank him. Hallelujah. Led him outside of the city. Praise God. Hallelujah. Spit in his eyes and, amen, healed the man of his blindness. He said, I see. Thank God, men as trees walking. I want you to know, hallelujah, then that God didn't stop there. Amen. Because God don't bring us halfway. Amen. He makes us all the way whole. Can the church shout hallelujah? Hallelujah. I was one, amen, that was bound in darkness, fetters of chains, and, amen, needed somebody to help me, but the Lord made me, thank God, all the way whole. He cuts everything off. Can the church say amen? Amen. The man, hallelujah, got to a place, amen, where he was able to see, praise the Lord, and Jesus was, hallelujah, in specificity to this man, spoke to him, and he says, hallelujah, go to
to your house and don't you tell anybody about what I did. Amen. Don't you go out in the town, praise God, and speak up a word to anybody. What are you trying to say, preacher? What I'm saying, hallelujah, never get to a place where God does not thank God any longer want to speak to you. Amen. God, hallelujah. Amen. And Christ had become fed up. Thank God with this particular city. Amen. They had rejected him. And he didn't want the benefits that came to this man to come upon any man. Amen. In that particular town, can the church shout hallelujah? Now, in order for you to understand why I'm saying this, you have to go back and read, thank God, the 11th chapter of the book, praise God, of Matthew, where he lets us know he had specifically called these cities out, praise the Lord, and upbraided them because of their unbelief. What Jesus was saying is, as a city, they had gotten their opportunity. They had gotten the opportunity to hear the truth. They had gotten the opportunity to receive the word of God. They had gotten the opportunity to, hallelujah, praise God, repent of those things. Thank God that was in their life. And I don't know about you. Amen. I want God, while I have space and time, I want, hallelujah, God to, thank God, speak to me. I want God to hear me. Can the church say amen? I want God to say, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of the Lord. Can the church shout hallelujah? Amen. We got to understand God will not always deal with man as he always have. There will come a time when God will say, amen, I'm no longer going to give opportunity. I'm no longer going to allow individuals, thank God, to hear my word. There's coming a time, even in history, amen, where men will run to and fro. Thank God, hallelujah, amen, seeking the word of God and won't be able to find it. There's going to come a time, brothers and sisters, when God will take the church out the earth. Amen. They be looking for the word, but the word has left. Amen. The word is going to leave with the church. Amen. I want you to know why Jesus, thank God, was walking down here in a body of human flesh. The word was made flesh. It dwelled among us. Hallelujah. The scripture said, amen, the grace and truth have come by. Thank God, Jesus Christ. Amen. Deacon Garner, they heard the word. The word spoke out of that body in Bethsaida. Thank God, hallelujah, Chorazin and Capernaum, it spoke out of that body. He was healing the blinded eyes. He was unstopping the deaf ears. People, amen, were being, hallelujah, healed. Thank God, all around them, but yet and still, amen, the unbelievers in those towns, thank God, were not willing to hear the word of God. And I don't know about you, saints of God. Amen. I want to, hallelujah, the word of the Lord Jesus Christ to take hold upon my life. Amen. Everybody's not going to hear, saints. Amen. But I come to tell us tonight, he's going to save those that will hear, those that will receive, those that will turn, hallelujah, to the truth and allow God to have free course and reign. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, in their life. Somebody say, thank God for the blind man. The blind man can also represent, thank God, a remnant of those, hallelujah, that God will have mercy upon. You see, there's always going to be somebody that's going to allow God to do what he wants to do in their life. Amen. So I come to tell us, it was time for us to come out. You see, if the man was going to be healed, saints, he had to come out of where he was. He had to come out the place that he was at, and he needed a change of scenery. He couldn't get the help of God where he was at. You see, every now and then, saints, we gotta move. Thank God when the Lord say move. Amen. God cannot bless us in certain places. You see, Bethsaida was not a place, amen, where the blessing of God was conducive. Every atmosphere is not conducive. Thank God for the Spirit of God moving. Amen. So the Bible tells us that Jesus took the man by the hand and said, follow me, I got something for you. And I hear the Bible saying, saints, that sometime we got to pick up our cross. Anybody willing to pick up their cross? Thank God and follow Jesus. Amen. I'll follow Jesus to the end of the earth. Amen. Whatever you want me to do, Jesus, I'll follow. I'll follow Jesus anywhere. This man was blind, didn't know where he was going. Amen. But he had to take Jesus, thank God, by the hand and say, Lord, I'm going with you. I don't know where I'm going, but I'm going with you. Amen. I come to tell somebody, you've been trying to do it yourself. But if you take Jesus by the hand, you can be like this blind man. You can walk out blind, but you can come in seeing. Can the church shout hallelujah? Amen. Capernaum, praise God. These towns were full of unbelief. And saints, we live in a day where people, amen, are rejecting God left and right. The world is blinded, saints. They cannot see the truth. Amen. Light is all around them, but they can't see that way home, praise the Lord. But somebody say, thank God for the blind man. Thank God for the blind man that was laying there, couldn't see where he was at. Amen. I don't know about you, but I also was blind. I was so blind, I thought I was smart. Amen. But I was actually a fool. Amen. Hallelujah. Ain't nothing like a fool who thinks he knows the way. Come on and shout hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm trying to get through this message. So what is the lesson behind it? Thank God, what I'm trying to say is that sometimes you got to switch. Thank God where you're at. If you're doing this, hallelujah, the same things, don't think that you're going to get a different result. You see, hallelujah, the blind man, saints, was not going to get out of his condition. If he stayed in Bethsaida, he was not going to be able to see. If he stood where he was at, he had to take the Lord by the hand. Anybody in here going to take Jesus by the hand? Anybody going to say, I may be in a place where I cannot see, but I'm going where my sight is. Sometimes your sight is on the other side of your situation. Sometimes your sight is this, hallelujah, one prayer away. Sometimes your sight is this, a phone call to Jesus. Thank God away. Don't call me 1-800. No, call Jesus. Come on and shout hallelujah. I hope you hear what I'm trying to say. Many mighty works was done, hallelujah, but God said, I'm tired of moving and nobody move in my direction. I'm tired of working and don't nobody listen to what I'm saying. I'm tired of working. I'm tired of healing sick and y'all calling me a devil. I'm tired of, thank God, I'm stopping the deaf ears. And you say, I got the spirit of Beelzebub. So he said, I'm going to take this man outside the city and y'all not going to get none of the blessing. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Hope you caught it. Hallelujah. You want to be blessed? You got to be in the place a blessing. You want God to give you what you need. I heard the Bible say, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly. Hallelujah. Nor standeth in the way of sinners. Nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But if delighteth in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. Y'all ain't gonna help me preach this morning. You see, some people wonder why I'm, hallelujah, they don't get nowhere because they're sitting in Bethsaida. They're still sitting in Capernaum. Amen. They still sitting in hallelujah. They're still sitting in a place where the blessing has moved on. You see, all the blessing has only come, amen, to your house if you're in the place where the blessing can reside. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Thank God one day when Jesus, thank God, spoke to me when he told me it's time to come out of my own house. Wowzer. It's time for me to come out the world. It's time, y'all don't hear me. It's time for me to come out of my spiritual Bethania. It's time for me to make a move. I didn't come out tiptoeing it, but come here, elder, hallelujah. But I grabbed Jesus by the hand and say, where you want me to go? I can't see me, but I heard the Bible sing me. Hallelujah, that we may feel after him, happily that we may find him. I wonder if you put your spiritual, thank God, fill us out and start saying, where's Jesus? I can't see him, but I heard about him. Y'all don't hear me. I heard about a man, hallelujah, that if somebody touch him, the hem of his garment, they'll be made whole. You're somebody ain't whole today, but I stop by to say, you need a change of scenery. You've been doing the same thing, expecting a different result. But if you call on Jesus, he'll answer prayer. If you call on the Lord and be of good courage, he won't let you down. I feel like preaching this morning. Y'all ain't gonna help me. I'm going to preach anyway. We living in a day, saints. People want you to do backflips. They want you to jump over a hoop and jump over a wall. But Jesus said, I'm tired of it. You don't believe me? I'm going to take this man outside the city and show my works. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Jesus said in one place, if you don't praise me, the rocks will cry out. I don't want no rock in me to cry out for me. Did he lead you one day? Did he guide you one day? Did he fill you one day? Did he make you whole one day? You need to praise him. You need to tell him you appreciate what he's done in your life. I was sitting in Bethsaida. I was bound. I was blinded. I couldn't see. But one day, Jesus grabbed me by the hand and come and said, walk with me. Y'all don't hear me yet. He said, walk with me. Led me by the hand. Said, turn around, huck in my eye and say, now can you see me? Now can you see me? Now can you see what I can do?
God trying to talk to people, but they sitting in Bethsaida. They sitting in a place where ain't no blessing at. God cursed the city. He cursed them, and he said, the mighty works that I did, hallelujah, were done here, was done in. Thank God, Sodom, if it was done where the wicked was at, they would have repented. God been talking for almost 2,000 years. And people still looking like, what are you talking about? Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. I'm getting out of the stadium and I'm going outside the town. I'm going out because I need a change of scenery. Where I'm at right now, I can't see Jesus. You can't see Jesus when you got blinders on. You can't see him when your eyes are blind. You can't see him. Hallelujah. But I come to tell you, hallelujah, you can pull the shades off. Thank God your eyes. And you can see the Lord. You will see him clearly. You will see him like you see the sky above your head. But you got to get out the city. And you got to go somewhere else where Jesus can move on your behalf. I gotta stop today. God ain't gonna work in certain places. So what's the lesson of the text? You need to change the scenery. Move from where you're at to where you get the blessing. You see, the blessing was no longer in Bethsaida. It's no longer there. It wasn't there anymore. Can the church say amen?
The blessing is where Jesus was leading them. You get the picture? So he had to change his scenery, his surroundings, so he can see what the Lord wanted to do for him. What's the purpose of why I'm hollering at you? You need to change your scenery, change your surroundings, change your association. Can the church say amen? Sometimes we got to change the people we hanging around, the people we listening to. Y'all don't hear, hallelujah, I'm gonna stop. Sometimes people wonder why they don't get nowhere because they sitting in the wrong place. This man was sitting blind in a city that was cursed. But God saw his heart. So when Jesus came by, they brought him to him. Brought the man to Jesus. Jesus said, I'm done dealing with y'all, but come on with me. Come here, Elder. I'm almost done here. I ain't gonna fool with them no more. I gave them a chance, but you come on. Hallelujah. Anybody that man in Bethsaida? Anybody that one man that Jesus said, Oh no. Your friends didn't forsook me. They don't want me. Amen. But come on with me. Come on, walk with me. I got something for you. Hey, where I'm going, I can't see. You may not be able to see right now. But if you keep on walking with me, amen, I'll take the blindness off your eyes. You got to believe God today. If you are sitting in a place where you cannot see, Jesus is, thank God, my light. I feel like preaching for a few minutes. He's my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Who are you afraid of? What are you afraid of? If you look at the light, darkness has to flee. If you look at the light, nothing can dwell in the light with Jesus that is dark. He can bring you out to death. He can make you lie down in safety. Can the church say amen? You get this Holy Ghost, you'll be able to go home, lock your door, and lie down in safety. I don't know, saints, if the man ever could see it in his life. But I know when Jesus got through with him, he had perfect sight. He had, somebody say 20/20. What did Jesus give us? He gave us our sight back. We were blinded. Some of us was blinded by our own ambition. Brother Terry, I remember the testimony of Brother Terry. Brother Terry said, well, you know, when I get grown, I'm going to do me, whatever that was, because some of us don't even know what it is. I know I didn't. I said, when I leave my mother's house, I'm doing what I want to do. I was a young fool, didn't know nothing. But I tell you about somebody. He grabbed me by the hand. I hope y'all hear what I'm trying to say. You better take his hand today. You better take the hand of Jesus. Take his hand. He can lead you out of the cursed place. Bethsaida was cursed. Can the church say amen? They were cursed. The city was cursed. Why? Because God had moved in that city so much. Lord Jesus Christ, they still didn't believe. But sometimes we just got to move beyond. Say, Lord, take me to a place where I get the blessing. Praise the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. And when he got outside, nobody around. The scripture don't tell us who was there all together. But we know at least it was Jesus and the man. And he wasn't in the city no more. And Jesus told the man, don't you tell nobody what I did. Can the church say amen? Took the man out, spit in his eyes, and told him, can you see now? One scripture said, concerning the Laodicean church, that he would anoint our eyes with eye salve.
that we may see. Sometimes we need God just to touch our eyes. I ain't gonna put my hand in your eye, Deacon. Just touch our eyes so we can see things clearly. We can see beyond what we feel, what we think. Because the Bible said he is the way. He is the truth and he is the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by him. See, the Jews in that day thought they knew the way. But when the way showed up, they called him a devil. They called him Beelzebub. Can the church say amen? They say he cast out devils by the prince of devils. Jesus said a house divided against itself can't stand. Why would the devil? See, the devil wants a house. He wants a host. Demons want a host. Why are they? Why would the devil cast himself out of his own host? That don't even make sense. No more than you would evict yourself out your own house. Can the church say amen? That don't make no sense. You got a house to live in, and now you want to tell yourself, I get out my house, so you're going to go outside and it's snowing out. Praise the Lord. He was trying to let them know, no, I'm not trying to harm you. I'm trying to get you closer to me. But because of their unbelief, God had to take a man to another place, put a blessing on him, and then take him, tell him to go home, and you don't tell nobody. Some things that God does for us is between, it's between us and God. We don't have to broadcast it. We don't have to tell everybody what happened, how he did it. You can commune with it upon your bed at night. Can the church say amen? I'm about to let you go. So what's the point? What's the narrative of the story? He needed to change the scenery. He needed to come out. Somebody needs to come out today. Singers can come. Somebody needs to come. They need to come out. You need to come to the waters of baptism. I'm gonna tell you how to get out now. You got to come to the water to have your sins washed away. You need to be filled with the baptism of the Holy Ghost to give you the power to live the life that God wants you to live. Somebody's in a place right now. You are in the valley of decision. You say, I don't know what this man's talking about, but listen to me closely. I'm trying to tell you how to get out. All those doubts, those fears, those issues that brought you to the house of God today, you need to change the scenery right now. Come on. You change the scenery right now. Come on. He's knocking. Who's that knocking? He's knocking. He's knocking at your door. Come on right now, right now. You hear him right now. Come on. Come out of Bethsaida right now. There's some sight on the other side of the town. Do you hear him? Do you hear him? The gospel's been preached. Now it's time for you to make the move to God and let your sight come back. Your body's hurting. Your mind is confused. Your spirit is in an upheaval. You can't figure things out. The Bible said that God is not the author of confusion. See, the enemy wants you to continue to be in a state of chaos. Life is topsy-turvy. Can't figure out why things are happening the way they're happening. They're happening because God is dealing with